As a photojournalist during the 60s and 70s, my photographs appeared in major magazines such as Life, Paris Match, and Stern. In this video, I'll be telling you all about the cameras I used, show you the photographs I took, and explain the technical problems that had to be overcome in order to capture them. In late August 1969, an outbreak of political and sectarian violence occurred in Northern Ireland. Today, this is often regarded as the beginning of the 30-year conflict known as the Troubles. I first went to Belfast in September of that year to cover the effects violence was having on children living in the slums of both the Catholic Road area and the Protestant Shankhill Road. This map from the Belfast Peace Wall archive shows the location of the Catholic and Protestant parts of the city, listing where conflicts flared over the decades. As in the slums of East London, Birmingham, Manchester and Liverpool, I found much poverty and deprivation, as well as great friendliness and companionship among children of the same religion. With no other playground, children in the Falls Road roamed the slums' narrow streets, and litter-strewn back alleys. Impoverished families were often forced to make ends meet by turning to high interest loans, and even in some cases, like this small girl, selling family possessions on the street. I was fortunate enough to meet a wonderful local doctor, Catholic Jim Ryan, who lived with his elderly mother and brother and had friends and clients on both sides of the sectarian divide. I photographed him being welcomed equally into both Catholics and Protestant homes, as in this picture showing him being greeted warmly by a devoutly loyal Protestant known locally as Orange Annie. My meeting with Jim was to save my life a few weeks later, as I shall explain in a moment. While some families, despite the surrounding squalor, lived in modest comfort, for others, like this single mother, life was a constant struggle to raise two young sons and a baby daughter in a dirty home without a bathroom. And with only a grubby slit of a kitchen. While the conflict was to become far, far worse during the 70s and early 80s, in February 1972, for example, I photographed the British Embassy in Dublin being set ablaze by the IRA. During my first visit in 1969, however, I recorded only a limited amount of damage. There were a few fire-gutted or bricked-up buildings lining the streets, some broken windows. And a young man whose head had been split open, he claimed, by a truncheon from one of the B specials. These were the Protestant police force, officers hated and feared by almost the entire Catholic community. In both Protestant and Catholic areas of the city, however, religious allegiances were abundantly clear and highly visible. Members of the Orange Order, the majority, strutted loudly and proudly through the streets during their marching season. Had plastered the walls of their streets with images of King Billy and anti-Catholic slogans. Catholics did the same in the streets around the Falls Road area. In September, for example, I attended a reunion of old IRA members. There I photographed this group of highly respectable bankers, doctors, lawyers, and wealthy business leaders. All former IRA men during the 20s and 30s, these men had, between them, been sentenced to almost 1,000 years in British prisons and prison hulks. My friend Jim Ryan can be seen here at the back row on the extreme left. Later I was to be kidnapped by a group of masked and armed young men who, believing I was a British spy, threatened summary execution. Fortunately, I was able to persuade them to phone Dr. Jim, who vouched for me, and I was released with profuse apologies. The last image I shot before leaving the Falls Road area was this group of young boys marching proudly down the street, waving the Irish flag. I often wonder what became of them and all the other bright, lively and smiling youngsters I photographed in the weeks before their world descended into a bloodbath terror. In my next video about the children of the 60s, I'll show you how they liked to play and amuse themselves in an age long before computer games, mobile phones, children's television programs, and social media. If you'd like to see some more of my photographs, please go to www.thewayitwas.uk. If you'd like to purchase a copy of my book, The Way It Was, then please go to the same website and take a look at what it contains. If you lived through the 60s, it will bring back some memories. If you never lived through the 60s, you'll find a foreign country where they do things very differently.